is Miriam Eulings. I'm a postdoc researcher at Maastricht University, and in the Recipes Project, I'm responsible for the case study on microplastics. We've looked at microplastics both in food and in cosmetic products, and in that way, we've included the environmental as well as the human health perspective. And this has been an interesting case for the precautionary principle, because there is a lot of scientific uncertainty with regard to the long-term effects of microplastic pollution. We've learned that this uncertainty is attributed for a large part to the lack of a definition of what actually is a microplastic. It's often described as a plastic particle of smaller than 5 millimeters. However, there is still a lot of variation with regard to its size, but also its shape, its material, its composition, and therefore also its toxicity. On the other hand, scientific uncertainty is caused because microplastics are very unstable once they are in the environment. So, for instance, when microplastics are in the ocean, they are under the influence of temperature changes and light, and this might change also their composition and their toxicity. And due to this uncertainty, there is a large knowledge gap, and only very limited scientific evidence is present to determine the long-term effects of microplastic pollution. Now, at the moment, the European Commission is working on a ban for intentionally added microplastics in cosmetic products. And this ban, via the REACH regulation, could be seen as an expression of the precautionary principle. And an interesting thing we learned during our case study is that actually, although this ban is not yet in place, industry is already working, in terms of innovation, to find more natural replacements in cosmetic products to replace these microplastics. To learn more about our project, please visit our website.